never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand.
I'll finish later, lad.
You were taken from this realm too early.
You who walks among the living, my beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really? How?
Boy,
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death, if only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Ah, good. The special chisel is ahead, past this gate.
Should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out
look
while
if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand. This chisel we seek, what is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamur. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, the quarrel of the air spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son. But in his emotional state, soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night. So far from home. Thor.
And what happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. Look, he fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty ballbag just got lucky.
A wolver!
A dangerous beast. We will take him down together.
Okay.
chisel?
The tip of one, yes. A very, very giant chisel.
That big crystal on the giant's ring looks promising. Darn, that didn't seem to do anything.
Oh, neat trick, lad.
Thanks. Good idea.
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything. Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Hostiles up ahead. Get to work. Ready, father! More arrows? An all-fine light crystal. Wonder what it's for.
What does it say?
Yes, sir. To Njord, we offer back the seas back.
Ah, yes. It was believed that Njord calmed the winds and seas for the fishermen. For that, they loved and worshipped him here.
There's something up there. Hardened world tree sap. That's handy. Well, here's the base for the crystal we saw. But how do we get it down? What's through here?
Atreus, follow me.
Yes, sir! How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Oh, no offense, brother, but I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy.
Right.
Wow, that was something, that fight. Here, catch. Well, that was a waste of a perfectly good hour.
How were you not seen? There is nowhere here to hide.
Oh, that. It's a little trick my people can pull. A special way of not being seen.
You can be invisible?
More like I can step into the realm between realms. And your mind doesn't understand what it's seeing, so it sees nothing at all. That's how we avoid ever having to actually use the weapons we craft. It doesn't seem to work on dragons, though.
Your brother wanted to know if you were getting enough to eat. I guess I could tell him you are.
Brock was asking about me?
Was there mead on his breath?
You let him touch this again. Come on, then.
So that's how Brock was in the temple right after the water drop. He stepped between realms.
Okay, now shush. I need complete silence for this. There you go. What can I do for you two? I think that's a keeper. Piece of work, if I say so much. Prepared in good health.
How about you, young one? It's like you were born in that armor. Something else for you, then? What can I do for you? To you. What a surprise. That was amazing. I don't suppose you could try keeping that going. But no. No, just it was a question. I'm fine.
So, this plan of yours.
Can you guess it?
Knowing you, it doesn't involve standing right here.
Correct.
But how do we move forward? Boy, Armor really liked jewelry, didn't he? Even braided his beard with it.
I happen to think he looks dashing. You know, for a snow-covered corpse.
My shop's right here!
Hey, Sindri, could you take a look at this?
Honestly? I don't have much else going on right now.
We heading into that building?
Yes.
You think there's something inside that'll help us break the ice and get to the chisel tip?
No.
I'll keep thinking.
I came here on a diplomatic mission once, trying to broker a peace between Asgard and Vanaheim. That war. So many lives lost. What I didn't know was Thor had already gone on a killing spree of giants.
What did the giants have to do with the war between the gods?
Nothing at all, lad. That's the tragedy of it. They took no side in that madness. But Odin's paranoia is surpassed only by Thor's lust for blood.
crystal. Just give the word.
Stealthy plan it is not.
Now we must free the other strap.
We do? And what we need is all the way down there.
Think.
Well, the chisel tip is under thick layers of ice, so melting it won't work.
Correct.
And there weren't any shattered crystals nearby for me to shoot, so that's not an option.
Correct.
That just leaves smashing the ice. We need something ridiculously heavy to... Oh, I get it now.
Good.
Going to turn the hammer so it lands near the chisel tip.
Not possible. We cut it free, write it down, and figure out what comes next after.
So your plan involves a whole bunch of luck, then?
You are welcome to suggest a different one. Hold tight.
This plan seems ill-advised.
Quiet head. Jump!
That didn't work. It only fell a little ways.
There's a sand bowl, but how do we get to it?
We cannot. Boy. What does it say?
When time itself is disarrayed, the forward path is retrograde. Retrograde? It's backwards?
Those symbols. The seasons?
Yeah, but the order's all jumbled. Shouldn't it be winter, spring, summer, autumn?
Why start with winter?
It's from a song Mother used to sing.
Don't I know that one? Winter, that...
Quiet, head.
Doesn't like music either. Got it.
Try that.
Vower, Haust, Vetter, Sumar. Nuh-uh. That wasn't right.
Write it.
Haust. Var... Sumar. Vetter. Still nothing.
Boy, the order from the song again.
Winter, spring, summer, autumn.
Try that.
Var. House. Sumar. Vetter.
Retrograde, lads.
What?
Of course. The riddle. The answer is reversed. Atreus, that word.
Thola. It means endure.
Try it.
Thola.
Well done, lad.
Write it again.
Thola. Horizon! The energy's lifting the platform.
Keep writing.
Thola.
Head. How is this possible?
My guess? Temporal magic. Dangerous stuff the High Vanir gods used to play around with. The ability to freeze time. Happened to be a favorite of Njord himself, in fact.
Used to? Why did they stop?
Well, turns out stopping time keeps the sun and moon from streaking across the sky. Unfortunately, it does not stop the wolves that chase them, always looking to sink their teeth in. After that, they decided it was best to leave time alone.
I can't get to the pole!
Back to writing, before the floor collapses.
Thola. 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 Thola.
Thank you.
good.
Having a little fun, you big grump.
Well, there it is. How are we going to get it free?
A push.
But
trust me. Ready. Dig in and push with everything.
Yes, sir.
Jump.
Really?
Come. Do not panic.
Why would I panic?
No. I have you.
Right, you know that.
Well. Good. We should keep moving.
The chisel tip.
Give the man credit. He has a talent for destroying things.
Remember that head.
Never leaves my mind.
Those were the guys we saw with Baldur. His nephews?
Aye. Magni and Modi. The sons of Thor.
Mother always said the Aesir were the worst of gods, and Thor was the worst of the Aesir. Guess he's a terrible father, too.
They are no longer children. They have no excuse.
Will Sindri be okay?
We'll never even see him. Ah, the great dining hall. Envy of all Midgard. Funny, I remember there being a massive candelabrum. Really livened up the place.
There.
Ah, yes. You just can't help but break things, can you? Memory serves, the Jarl's throne was just on the other side of that wall of ice.
Something ahead.
See, lad? He's fine.
Thought it best to vanish when Thor's idiot sons showed up. Wait, no. Yes. Come in. That's fine. Always happy just to chat. I don't have much else going on right now.
I mean it. He went to war with Uncle and walked away.
Maybe. Uncle hadn't seen straight in years. As long as father believes in my son, so you will stop talking. Focus. You can't disappoint father. Oh, smack you, boy. No, you cannot disappoint father. Now keep looking.